So I actually started this project a minute ago and forgot to video it. Well, I didn't think I was going to video it. So here we go. Yes. So here we go. I've got an old Maul. And it's one of those generic ones. I looked it up. I can't find out who made this Maul. I'm not sure. It says wear safety glasses on it. And it's stamped M6 right over here. Not sure who made it, but whatever. Basically what happened here, I got a little bit ahead of the video, but I'll show you what I did. Basically what I had was this Maul was moving around. The head was all over the place doing exactly that. Somebody had whoever had it before me, there was a nail jammed in it here to tighten it up. I mean, whatever, it's a cheap fix, it works. Anyway, I took that out and I had to get out the wedge to get this thing seated properly. So basically the wedge is this guy here. I've never seen that before. It's a full-size aluminum wedge, and it was obviously flush, as well as the handle was flush to this head. So I had to get access to it. And the way I did that, and it's a quick fix, really, if the handle's in good shape, you can do it. And it's not my trick. People have been doing this forever. So I'll show you what I did to get this out and to fix this axe up, or this Maul, axe or Maul, whatever. It'll work with both. This guy was flush at the top, and I had to get this to protrude out a bit so I could get at the wedge. This here at the handle, it had an actual, there was like a 90 degree little ledge that this head was sitting on. So it wouldn't, the head won't go down. So what I had to do was I just knocked off, it was real quick, didn't take long. I just filed off that ledge all the way around the handle. Basically, you know, it was worse in other places and not so bad in other spots. But anyway, I just knocked that edge off so that I could get this handle up inside and get this wedge protruding and I can get at it. So that's been filed off. Again, it only took a few minutes. And now we're gonna get this handle to protrude out here. And there's a couple ways you can do that. You can just bang the handle, grab the head, and bang it on the end of the handle on the ground until it comes up. Or whack the handle to get that handle protruding through the wedge. So I've got it flipped upside down. I'm gonna lift the head off the ground, of course, and I'm just gonna whack this handle. I couldn't find my ball peen, but I got a rubber mallet, that'll work. Just takes a couple whacks. So there you have it, I've got this is coming up through. It was flush in the beginning, and now it's up through. So basically what I did was, this again was also flush with this. Now that gave me room to get a hammer claw on the back, and you can see the marks from the claw actually, and pop it out. Again, this is a full-size aluminum wedge. I'm not gonna put this back in. It'd probably be fine though. Anyway, and that's how I got it out. I wiggled it on both sides, and boom, out it came. And that's the wedge. Again, now that I've got this out, I'm gonna go over it with the file again and make sure this thing's seated all the way around. It's not, you know, there's no gaps or anything. I'm gonna get it as good as I can. It's gonna be just some filing until it's looking good. And I'm gonna pound this guy back into the handle a few times until I get it where I want it, and then I'll put a new wedge in it. Okay, so here you go. Normally I would put some wood between this if it was a half decent axe head. This is an old beater Maul, so I'm not really worried about it. So you see how much I've taken off it. That's the how much it's moving around now since I've taken off those little ledges that were here. And it's starting to fit really good. Still rocking a bit, you can see that. So I'm gonna hit it with the file a few more times. I'm gonna pound it a couple more times as well. And you can see where it's hitting on that ledge. Here, I'll show you. So you can see that, that's the mark now, it's made. That's what I gotta take off. Maybe a bit off that heel too. Yep, but you can see it just rocking. So I'm gonna get rid of that, hit it with the file a few more times. Again, just a quick fix, this is pretty easy to do. It's a lot easier than putting on a new handle, that's for sure. That's looking better already, still a bit of a rock, so. Anyway, I'm gonna get to that, and I keep filing it, whacking it, and get it where I want it. So there you go, this guy is solid. Again, not really concerned about this one too much. Did a little bit of light pressure on that. I've totally taken it up maybe a quarter inch. So this guy's ready for a wedge, and I'll do that next, and this thing will be good as new. So I'm just gonna make the same size wedge. I don't have any store-bought wedges, so I'm gonna make one. I'll just check it. And you know what, that should be fine. This isn't very deep, so should be good. There it is, my homemade fancy pants wedge. Just gonna jam in there. I'm not gonna glue this. I don't know if glue makes a difference, if this is gonna be expanding and contracting the wood. If I put white glue in there, you know what, I just usually don't. So It probably works. I don't know. I'm just not going to do it. I'm going to whack this in and then we'll go to the next step. Okay, I got to take a little bit more of this wedge off. It's a little bit too fat down low. I got to make it more of a wedge shape. If I can get it out. Yeah, there you go. I just got to knock a little bit of this off. I just hit it with a belt sander and I'll be right back. Okay, back. So I was kind of trying to cheat there. It wasn't much of a wedge shape, so it is now. It's better. So let's do that again. Oh yeah, I found the ball peen hammer. Nice. I'm just gonna clean this up a bit. I'll leave this handle. I'm not gonna cut it flush. I'm gonna leave it like this. I'll just clean up this top wedge. Obviously you can do this with whatever you got. If it's sticking out enough, just use a little hacksaw or a little, you know, a good blade. This is the Zero Tolerance 350 ST with the S30V steel. Love this thing, man. I've had it for years. Okay, that's pretty good. Gonna be laying a beating on. It's gonna be splitting wood, so I'm not really concerned about the finish here. So now I'm gonna pop in some metal wedges here. Okay, I'm just gonna put one in here. I don't have any smaller ones for this. This guy's pretty fat, so I'm gonna put him in on an angle and I'm gonna put him dead center. Looking good. There you go, and fast motion, and that's cranked in there. That's not going anywhere. I already gave it a sand and a coat of pure linseed oil, but I'm gonna do that again. I'm gonna pour some up on top here and let it soak, and I'll be splitting wood with it soon. So this is pure linseed oil, and I'm just gonna let that soak. I'll do the handle a couple more coats. There you go, it turned out pretty good. I've got a couple coats of linseed oil on it, and if you wanna see a real Axeman's channel, check out Buckin' Billy Ray Smith. He's out of BC and he's got an awesome channel. Check it out. I'll put a link in the description. Thanks for watching.